You're listening to PetLifeRadio.com.
I am Seth Peterson.
I am Debbie Hedren.
I'm Rhonda Schwartz.
I'm Josh Roberts.
This is Jesslyn Gilson.
Hello, I'm Victor Webb.
Hi, this is Charlotte Ross.
Hi, this is Ed Begley Jr.
What's up, you guys? This is AJ from the Backstreet Boys.
Hi, this is Shannon Elizabeth, and you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. And you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets.
With Jon Patch.
Jon Patch.
You're listening to Talkin' Pets with Jon Patch.
Hello, America, and welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch. Join Jon and his expert guests with all of your pet questions, concerns, comments, and stories. Now it's time for Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch.
And welcome to Talkin' Pets, heard coast to coast on your favorite radio station. This is Talkin' Pets, and I'm Jon Patch. Joining us is
Dr. Jared Lazarus from the Bay Area Veterinary Care Center in Lutz, Florida.
Here to answer your medical questions and your behavior questions about your pets at 844-287-2876. That's 844-287-ATRN. When you call into that number, you'll speak with Mr. Zach Buten, and he'll put you on the line with us.
I'm a stud.
So give him a call at 844-287-2876. The show is produced in-house, in-studio, by the ever-so-lovely and talented Miss Lexi Lapp. Hi, Lexi.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good.
You ready?
Yep.
We have a special guest joining us in this hour. His name is Larry Kay. He's the author of Life's a Bark, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. It's a great book, and there's going to be some great conversation and quotes from this. We're going to give away a couple of books as well, so stay tuned. But that's Mr. Larry Kay. He's going to be joining us, the author of the book, Life's a Bark. The show is brought to you in part by Earth Friendly Natural Pet, the number one stain and odor remover in the country. That is Earth Friendly. But once again, I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And Lexi Lapp.
And this is Talkin' Pets. Larry Kay believes that when he or we discover pets, we discover ourselves. He co-authored the award-winning Training the Best Dog Ever with Bo Obama's dog trainer, the late Don Sylvia Stavichitz, something like that. I'll let him tell that one. He also created and produced Animal Wow, which has become the most award-winning dog care and safety DVD for kids. His canine journalism credits include columnist and contributing editor for Dog Fancy magazine and reporting on the Westminster Dog Show for AOL. Now, Larry's best pet projects include editorial relationships in animal welfare endorsed by the AHA and Veterinarians American Animal Hospital Association. As a motivational speaker, Larry talks to audiences and mentors individuals with wisdom from Life's a Bark, inspiring people to pursue their life's missions and achieve peak performance. When his schedule permits, he also helps people train their dogs, always using reward-based positive training. Larry celebrates our human-animal bond by creating and producing world-class media projects, including a forthcoming dog themed reality TV series. He has produced and written for Disney, The Muppets, and PBS. Larry's popular Facebook page shares daily inspiration, news, and entertainment with dog-loving fans. He invites you to share your canine life, love, and photos. You can visit Larry online, of course, at www.positivelywoof.com. We want to welcome on the Talkin' Pets, Larry Kay, the author of Life's a Bark. Hey, Larry, how you doing?
I'm great, Jon. Thanks for having me.
It's great to have you, and you got to correct me. I was totally off on Don Sylvia
Stavichitz.
No wonder why I couldn't get it.
You know, through writing that award-winning book with Don, I really learned that the more we train our dogs and the more we shape them into our ways of living, the more we learn how to live a richer life. And we learn about the big things like love. And that's what inspired me to write Life's a Bark. So I really appreciate the opportunity to share this wisdom with your audience, John.
Well, I want to introduce you right off the bat to Dr. J here, Dr. Jared.
Hi, how are
you? Dr. J. Great.
And, of course, Lexi, our producer over here.
Hello.
Hey, Lexi.
And I want to get right into the book. First of all, who's the publisher on the book?
Source Books. It's a great independent publisher out of the Chicago area. They had a bunch of bestsellers last year, and they're very excited about this book that just came out, and really pleased with how they've been helping to get the word out.
So I would imagine it's available on in bookstores and also available probably on Amazon and all?
Absolutely, yeah. Both, if you go to the website positivelywoof.com or to my Facebook page, which is facebook.com/positivelywoof, you'll get links to all the online booksellers. And if you do have an actual bookstore in your town, I invite you to go into the bookstore there to purchase it, or if they don't have it, to order it there.
You know, it's really pretty awesome, actually, the way that you put this book together. First of all, who did the photography on it? Because I love the pictures in the book.
Well, thank you so much. I got a bunch of different photographers and licensed their photos, and it was really such a treat to go through and really pick just these great photos and to set them up so that they would, you know, look really good and, you know, inspire me, and I hope inspire others for a long time to come.
Now, I like the way you start off with, like, for instance, on page 12 of the book, you start off with this explanation. Well, the title is "I Always Miss You," and then you put in there a "Try This." Now, on the "I Always Miss You," you've got "Even though we try to reassure them when we leave that everything will be okay, many dogs have anxiety when they are left alone. They show distress by making a lot of noise, destroying stuff, or trying to escape. We humans are social animals just like dogs. We miss loved ones, friends, and even inanimate things and places. But can we figure out how to embrace our moments of solitude even when we feel the pain of loneliness? And first of all, I love the way you put that together, because a lot of us in the world are going through that loneliness. But
I hear that. It's, you know, as a writer, there sometimes is a fine line for myself alone here in my creative studio sometimes when my assistants aren't around. And to understand what is the difference between solitude and loneliness. And this, I learned from dogs how to have the solitude appear more times than the loneliness. And yet sometimes I know that dogs feel lonely because they do always miss us.
And what is the "try this"? Now tell us like a little bit, I mean, because you have on here, the next time you feel lonely, allow yourself 5 minutes to howl.
You know, let's take a page out of the dog's playbook of life. Let's just say, okay, I'm lonely. I'm going to act like a dog. I am going to howl. I'm going to do it for a full-on 5 minutes. And then, at the end of 5 minutes, I get to make a decision. Am I going to continue to embrace loneliness, or am I going to continue to embrace something else? Because it's ultimately a choice, whether I want my emotions to control me, or whether I want to just walk with my emotions contained. So I invite your listeners that if they feel lonely, go ahead and howl for 5 moments, then make a choice, and part of that choice I invite is to do something nice for yourself. When we do something nice for yourself, you know, it's about being positive, it's about rewarding. So that's the tip for "I Always Miss You." Thanks for seeing that one, John.
Yeah, I like that one. And there's a couple other ones in here that I want to get into with you. We're going to take a little break, but when we come back, we're going to continue on talking about Life's a Bark by Larry Kay, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. What we're going to do is, and this is a great book. It's a great book to share with friends. It's not a huge book that you can, you know, you could take it with you anywhere, take it to the beach, take it, you know, if you're going on a picnic. It's an absolute wonderful book, great photography in it, and I love the quotes about life. We all need something like this in our life, and it's a great book. Like I said, Life's a Bark by Larry Kay. Larry's going to be right back with us. We're going to take a little break and continue on, but we're going to send away a book to somebody right now. If you call, and you're the third caller, number three, to call in to Zach, our producer, at 844-287-2876. That's 844-287-2876. Call right now. It's a toll-free telephone number, and the book, Life's a Bark, is yours. 844-287-2876. I'm John Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lab.
Don't forget, you can check out more information as well on my website, talkinpets.com, TALKINPets.com. Check the news section right there on the homepage, and you'll see Life's a Bark as well. This is Talkin' Pets.
It's dinner time in America, where more pet parents trust PetSmart for natural and expert-recommended foods than any place else. And now, we've added more than 100 new varieties to our already wide selection of your favorite brands, like Simply Nourish, Authority, Wellness, Science Diet, and more. Do what's best for your pet. At PetSmart, happiness in store.
Go to PetSmartDeal.com to find out this week's coupon code and save up to 30% on food, treats, toys, and more. And get free shipping on orders of $49. Go to PetSmartDeal.com, PetSmartDeal.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
When I met you in the summer, so my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown, and we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so innocent now, but you lied so soon. When I met you in the summer.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm John Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lapp.
And you are listening to Talkin' Pets. Give us a call at 844-287-2876. That's 844-287-2876. That's the number to call. When you call in, you'll speak with Mr. Zach Buten. He'll put you on the line with us. And we're giving away a couple books as well of Life's a Bark by Mr. Larry Kay. If you call right now, you got a copy coming out to you. 844-287-2876. 844-287-2876. Larry, I wanted to ask you on page 16 of your book, Life's a Bark, you get into I'm beautiful and so are you. Dogs can see the supermodel in us. Can we see it in them and in ourselves? Beauty is being comfortable in our own skin, regardless of what we look like. Self-love and self-acceptance are keys to unlocking the door to true beauty. Love your writing.
Thank you. You know, I love the photo that's on that page. It is a Chinese-crested mutt, and that breed tends to be in the finals of the ugly dog contest every year, and people just love this particular photo. So, it's self-love is really the key to our being able to walk in the world as and bringing beauty into the world. When we start with the beauty in ourselves, then we can really bring it well into the world.
You know, also you get into, when you say to try this, while you're in the shower, say you're beautiful as you scrub every part of yourself.
Yes. Yep. Body shame in America is so common that it's time to really reclaim just our bodies as we are, imperfect in all of us, and to just love that. We will be more powerful, peaceful, better people, better citizens, just as dogs teach us to be with their own bodies.
How did you think about putting all this together, though? I mean, like these write-ups and then the try this. Where'd you come up with that idea?
Well, thank you. Part of it was an inspiration from the dog training book that, you know, won those awards. As I was writing that book, I really began to realize how much of this was important to my living myself, a good life. And so I thought, well, I want to, in my next life, I want to come back as my dog. and so, John, I want you to treat me like a dog. You know, maybe it sounds funny, but, you know, the days when being treated like a dog was a bad thing, those days are long gone. You know, today's dogs are living the good life. And I think there's a lot that we can learn from that. Woof wisdom, it's simple. It's often stuff that we know, but that we're too busy to remember. So dogs help us to remember to live well.
on page, another one of your quotes on, in the pages here of your book, Life's a Bark, I respect you. Dogs naturally respect humans who take care of them. They express respect for those same things over and over and over. What is it like to respect others and others the way dogs respect us? Can we show that respect repeatedly? You're try this, pretend you're a dog. Look at yourself in the mirror, smile like a dog, and say three things you respect yourself for. Say the same three things again until you begin to believe them.
I'm really glad you pointed to that one. It's easy for us to tell others those critical things about ourselves, or even if somebody gives us a compliment to, aw, shucks. And I want us to really claim in a healthy way the goodness that we bring to the world. And the more that we embrace our gold, the more we'll be a force for good in the world. Dogs do that naturally. Dogs just bring it as it is. They are completely authentic. They are happy to show off. They just love being acknowledged. And when we do the same things, when we treat ourselves like dogs, we can bring our gifts to others and create better lives around us.
You're easy to love. Do dogs really love unconditionally? While we humans sit and debate whether that's true, dogs are content to accept us as we are. Acceptance and self-assurance are the core of a dog's love. So is loyalty, sweetness, patience, protection, playfulness, respect, adoration, and don't forget, slobbery kisses. Now, your try this is kiss yourself and say, I love you and accept you as you are. Lexi, you know that one over there, don't you?
Yeah. I like to kiss myself in the mirror.
I need to do that more often, apparently.
Yeah, dogs accept us as we are. They treat us like royalty, even when we may not deserve it. They don't judge us, they forgive us, and they show us how to love unconditionally. Now, there's some debate around whether dogs actually do love us unconditionally, but as I point out in the book, it's like, well, while we're debating whether they are really unconditional, the dogs are just doing what they're doing. They're giving us those slobbery kisses. I just think, you know, couldn't we all use a dose of that in our lives? You know, couldn't we accept others a little better? Couldn't we tell ourselves, I love you? Because self-love and acceptance, those are the keys to unlocking the door to our true beauty.
You know, right in the middle of the book, it's close to the middle of the book, actually, you have it's a big picture of two dogs carrying a stick, and it says, play well with others, share.
Amen. That's a
cool picture.
I'm really glad that you pointed that out. I believe in having a personal mission statement in life, and it's, you know, how we walk in the world, and playing well with others is a big part of my personal mission statement, which in full is, I empower a creative world of abundant mastery by serving with ease and playing well with others.
Larry, can you stay with us a little bit longer?
I would love to, John.
Life's a Bark by Larry Kay, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. I don't know about you guys out there across America, but I'm getting a lot of messages out of this book that I need right now in my life. So I think it's a great book. I highly recommend it. You can find it in bookstores. You can find it online. Again, Life's a Bark by Larry Kay. But if you call right now, a book is yours. Compliments of Larry and Talkin' Pets. We'll send that out to you. Just give us a buzz. You can speak with Zach. Tell him you want the book, Life's a Bark, and it's yours. 844-287-2876. That's 844-287-2876. Call right now, and the book is yours, Life's a Bark, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. And we all need to learn more about that, for sure. 844-287-2876. 844-287-2876. You're listening to Talkin' Pets. Check us out on the web at TalkinPets.com. And please join us on Facebook and Twitter. We've got 20,000 following us. We want 20,000 more. That's once again, TalkinPets.com. No G in the talking. I'm John Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lab.
And this
dopey.
Is Talkin' Pets.
I'm not much of a reader, but I do wish I were more well-read.
There are so many great books coming out. I wish I could find a way to keep up.
Audible.com makes it easy to stay well informed and catch up on your reading simply by listening. Audiobooks from Audible turn downtime into uptime. You'll be more productive and become well-read.
Now I'm able to catch up on all the great books I've been wanting to read.
With Audible, I feel smarter.
Pet Life Radio listeners, try Audible.com now and get your first 30 days of Audible Listener Gold Membership plan free. And get a free audiobook. Choose from over 100,000 titles. To get this great deal, go to audibledeals.com. That's audibledeals.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jeff Werber from Ask the Vets with Dr. Jeff here on Pet Life Radio, and we want to hear from you. I am now with you every Sunday morning at 9 a.m. Pacific time. I hear him in the West Coast. That makes it noon back in the East here on PetLifeRadio.com. So when we get callers who call in a question about their pet or email me a question that I read live on air, Kong is going to send out a free Kong toy. So you get free advice, lots of information, and a ProSense and or a Kong toy just for calling in here to Ask the Vets with Dr. Jeff on Pet Life Radio. That is a great deal. So you can call in at 877-385-8882. Or you can drop me an email to drjeff at petliferadio. We want you to take advantage of me, because that's why I'm here.
Every week, on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's talk pets.
Let's talk pets.
On Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
With this hour's Talking Pets news from the USA Today, here's your host, Jon Patch.
In Brewer, Maine, a bald eagle found sick and disoriented on a Bangor sidewalk last month had made a full recovery and been released into the wild. The female eagle was released in Brewer on Tuesday, not too far from where she was originally nesting. Dr. J?
Out of Tallahassee, Florida, Republican Governor Scott has signed into law a new $77 billion budget, but vetoed nearly $69 million in individual spending items, including money for a Miami observation tower and a dog park. John?
In Roxbury, Vermont, the state is trying to get the federal emergency management to help pay for repairs to the fish hatchery there. Restoring the hatchery is the state's largest remaining Irene repair project. At issue is whether FEMA should help for a replacement hatchery that meets federal clean water standards.
At a Montpelier, Vermont, there have been more bald eagle sightings in Vermont. The State Department of Fish and Wildlife said in 2013, 26 nests were found in and around the state. John?
And in Dover, New Hampshire, a $5,000 reward is being offered for information leading to an arrest and conviction in two recent loon shootings. The loons were found, actually, with bullet wounds last month, 50 miles apart in Dover and Moultonboro. Both died.
Out of Cable, Wisconsin, some northern Wisconsin business owners are concerned about how new restrictions on deer hunting will impact their bottom line. The 9-day gun deer season is one of the busiest times of the year. John?
In Port Huron, Michigan, the $6 million Blue Water River Walk opens today. Now a 15-ton steel sculpture of a sturgeon by Lou Rodriguez of South Haven has already been installed.
Out of Detroit, Michigan, the Buddy's Pizza Chain is using its leftover dough to create Buddy Bones dog treats. John?
So your dogs are now eating pizza.
That's right. That's perfect.
In Campton, New Hampshire, the White Mountain National Forest will help mark 50 years since the Wilderness Act was signed, protecting millions of acres of wild lands in the United States. Once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lapp.
We welcome your calls and questions at 844-287-2876. That's 844-287-2876. We're speaking with the author of Life's a Bark, Mr. Larry Kay. If you've got a question, give us a call, 844-287-2876. And also check us out on the web at talkinpets.com. That's T-A-L-K-I-N, pets.com. And join us on Facebook and Twitter. You're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like that's what you want.
And you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lapp.
844-287-2876 is the number. 844-287-2876. If you'd like to get a copy of the book, Life's a Bark, we're giving out complimentary copies to from Larry Kay. What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. Call right now, 844-287-2876. And the book is yours, 844-287-2876. On page 74 of Life's a Bark, I don't have to like everyone, and not everyone likes me. Dogs tend to tolerate our idiosyncrasies and seemingly arbitrary behavior far better than we tolerate theirs. Not liking someone or not being liked by someone doesn't mean that we need to be disrespectful or unkind to them, but rather that our tastes and desires just don't mesh with theirs. Understanding and respecting our differences is a big part of having authentic, honest, and ultimately happier interactions. Now, Larry says, try this. Laugh at an idiosyncrasy of yours. Bonus points for having a friend or loved one laugh with you. I like that one too, Larry.
I'm glad you pointed that one out. I get a big chuckle out of that. You know, when I'm in my fear, I am afraid to show you, to show others, you know, that I have faults too. That, I'm human and have faults. And what I embrace just who I am and just am content with being that way, I realize that not everybody has to like me. And that's okay, because it starts with my self-love. And as long as I'm doing good acts in the world, I'm okay with going forward, living my life the way I'm living my life. Dogs do that so easily. They don't know any other way to be except for being themselves.
You know, Lexi was just playing the song "Be Happy," and
I love
here,
that song.
Yeah, it's a great song. "Show Me the Happy" is part of the book here too. Life's a Bark. Many dogs seem to have endless joy and optimism. They're also naturally brilliant at showing their excitement and happiness, even with a simple tail wag. The more we practice showing the happy, the better we get at it, and the better we'll feel. Even forcing ourselves into a little happiness can change our whole mindset and bring happiness to ourselves and others. And I like your try this. The next time you feel sad or cranky, don't fight it. Be grumpy for 5 minutes, then pretend to be happy for one full minute, then choose to be grumpy or happy for the next 3 minutes. Repeat as necessary, and you'll be smiling genuinely before you know it.
So the thought with that, I'm really glad you chose that, because that just cracks me up. And the photo that's on that dog, on that page, just of that dog being held with a tongue hanging out of its mouth, it's just hilarious. In 10 minutes, I can change my state into happiness, and I believe most people can. Even if it's just for a moment, even if it's just that touch to realize that this sadness that I may be feeling, or this fear, or this anger, won't last forever. That if I can just practice this little exercise of pretending to be happy, then I can actually begin to realize that I'm going to be changing my state. Well, I can learn that from a dog very easily. And sometimes, just like that dog in that photo, I will practice being happy by wagging my tail if I have one, you know, shaking my booty, jumping up and down, wagging my tongue, barking, sniffing stuff. You know, it's really pretty easy. This whole woof wisdom stuff is pretty simple. It's, you know, dogs help us to remember this stuff.
Larry, I have a question. On page 84, you have something, an instant attitude adjustment. And under try this, I was wondering how this is possible. The next time you have a setback, pretend for 1 minute that you're a dog. Wag your tail, run in circles, hop, bark, smile, pant. It will take the edge off for a moment and may change your state of mind for the whole day.
Exactly.
I can't get over, I don't have a tail.
You know, if you think you do, the men in the little white suits might be coming for you.
In the Twinkie Mobile.
You know, you could just shake your booty, or you could put your arm behind you and pretend that you've got a tail and wag it around.
Could then get arrested.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's you do have a tail,
really,
but...
Shaking my booty around the office place.
That's right, yeah, and bring your dog to work day, which is coming up in a couple of weeks. everybody should be wagging their tails that day, huh?
You know, on also in your book here, Be Quick to Forgive, you talk about, you know, as long as dogs trust us, they forgive our mistakes easily. They look with optimism for the best in us. But when dogs don't trust us, they're always on guard. When it is easier to forgive another's mistakes, when we are able to feel grateful and remember the abundance in life, it is easier to forgive mistakes. Don't does forgiveness seem like we're being pushovers? Can we forgive and also have healthy boundaries? You say try this. Forgive yourself, and then you can forgive others. You'll feel better for it, guaranteed.
True.
I like that one. I mean,
I'm really glad. Yeah, self-forgiveness is very important. There's a fantastic author by the name of Brené Brown, and she talks about the emotion of shame and helped me understand that shame is anger directed inward, anger directed at myself. So if I can reduce the anger with myself, I can love myself, I can embrace myself, I can forgive myself. Once I am in self-forgiveness, I become accepting. And dogs are the masters of self-acceptance. You know, you'll see a dog, it's, you know, the dog has done something wrong, chewed up something. I come home and my dog is showing me the what I call the slinky shoulder move. And it's like, what did we chew up? What did we do? And so, you know, we deal with, we chewed up a cushion. We deal with that behavior, not, with any severe punishment, but just by really ignoring that thing and redirecting his behavior towards something positive. And then in under a couple of minutes, it's fine. It's forgotten. It is, we're on to the next. We're having fun again. We're in love again. You know, it's said that maybe there's two ways of being when it really boils down to it. There's being in love or there's being in fear. And so that the forgiveness piece is about being in love.
Well, I got to tell you, Larry, I love your book, Life's a Bark by Larry Kay, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. Larry, it's a great pleasure having you on with us. I want to thank you for joining us here on the program. And I look forward to your next book coming out because this one is absolutely phenomenal.
I'm really thrilled, and it's so cool to see how the fans on my Facebook page are embracing that already and giving their own examples of how dogs teach them about life and love. And I certainly invite your listeners to do the same, to come to Facebook/PositivelyWoof.
Sounds good. Larry, thank you so much for joining us here on Talkin' Pets, and look forward to talking with you again, and have a great weekend.
I do as well, John. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. J and Lexi.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's Mr. Larry Kay, the author of Life's a Bark, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. A great book. It's a great read. You can get a lot out of it. So make sure you check it out in a store near you, or you can check it out online. You can also check out his facebook.com/positivelywoof, W-O-O-F. So check it out. There's information, too, posted on our website under the news section at talkinpets.com, T-A-L-K-I-N, pets.com. We're going to give away two books, so if you call right now, they're yours. The number to call, 844-287-2876. It's a toll-free telephone number. It means the call's on us, of course. And the book is, too. Compliments of Mr. Larry Kay, the author of Life's a Bark. So call us, 844-287-2876. That's 844-287-2876. Call right now, and the book, Life's a Bark, goes out to the next two callers. 844-287-2876. We're open to your medical questions and your behavior questions. I'm John Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lab.
Pick up the phone. Give us a call. We want to talk to you. 844-287-2876. But if you call right now and you speak with Zach, he's going to send you out a book. Call and it's yours. Life's a Bark by Mr. Larry Kay.
Dyson. The new Dyson Animal Vacs are powerful bagless upright vacuums for homes with pets. Air muscle and radial root cyclone technology generates the strongest suction power to powerfully remove dust, dirt, and pet hair from the home or car. To order your Dyson Animal Vac, go to DysonDeals.com. DysonDeals.com to order your Dyson Animal Vac today.
Dyson.
music to your ears.
Hi, I'm Dr. Robin Gansert, President and CEO of American Humane Association, the country's first national humane organization. Here to tell you about our new show, Be Humane, on Pet Life Radio. Each week, we'll be bringing you the latest news and issues affecting our animal friends, and we'll also be bringing you interviews with Hollywood's biggest animal advocates, here to share tales about their pets and what they're doing to promote a more humane world. Our own highly experienced staff and friends of the organization will also join us each week to share what they're up to in the animal world. I hope you'll stop by. Until then, let's always remember to be humane.
Every week on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's talk pets.
Let's talk pets
on Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Lexi Lapp.
Let's try that one again.
And I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
There you go. You know, we just said goodbye to Life's a Bark, Larry Kay. He wrote the book, Life's a Bark, What Dogs Teach Us About Life and Love. And I didn't want to actually say goodbye without talking about this one. And it's at the end of the book. But I think it's interesting. Life After Dog. Dogs Teach Us About Loss. To have a dog is to sign up for the inevitable sadness that we will probably outlive our companion, our friend, that sometimes knuckle-headed beast who perhaps accepted us more than we accepted ourselves. To deny the pain is to deny that we live, that we love, that we matter to each other, and our canine companions would never want that. Now, Larry says to try this. If you are grieving a loss, human, canine, or otherwise, honor your feelings. What you feel keeps your loved ones alive in your heart, connecting you with them always.
That is really good.
No, it's a great message. This is a great book. And we do have one more to give away. So if you want to call 844-287-2876, Maria in Murfreesboro, Tennessee is getting a copy, and Roger in Norcross, Georgia. So enjoy the book, you guys, because it's a great book. I mean, there's a lot of great messages in this. I really like this book.
Yeah, I love the pictures. The pictures are priceless.
Yeah, photography is definitely phenomenal. You know, it's like when we were talking about loss with your dog and everything like that, not to get on the downer, but it's just like I hear it from friends and family on those moments when you have to make that decision. And as a veterinarian, Dr. J, I would imagine you've been in your office or your clinic or, you know, whatever, in the operating room or wherever it happens, or what do you call that room, the examining room, when you have to put a dog to sleep and the dog's parents are there and the family and all. It's traumatic.
It's traumatic for everyone involved. I thought at the beginning of my career that it would get easier as I got older. It's gotten harder.
Really?
To put animals to sleep. It's heart-wrenching. And to see these owners, the grief in their eyes and just bawling, it breaks my heart.
You know what I think is interesting is that I just grabbed something out of what you just said. As you've gotten older, as I've gotten older, I think, and maybe it's a misconception of my own because of personal things right now, but the thing is that I think people, when they get older, I would hope anyway, understand love more and desire it more, and that companionship and wanting to be around someone. I think when you're younger, the younger generation thinks life goes on, they'll never die. It's like, okay, if this doesn't work, then that will. I find that with a lot of the younger generation this day and age. Whereas in the older people, like ourselves, we look at life and love a little bit differently than the younger generation.
I don't know. Let's ask the younger generation.
That's true.
Lexi Lapp, do you fear death?
Yes.
Do you?
Yeah, I'm afraid. I don't. I fear growing old more than I fear.
Oh, thanks. What's that? Not the first or the last time I've heard that. Growing old.
It beats the alternative, Lexi.
Dying, yes, I suppose. But I am afraid to... I'm more afraid of growing old than dying. I'm not necessarily afraid of death as I am of getting older.
Now, what is it that scares you about getting older, being 20 right now?
Just... Is I it,
based on because of looks or based on health or
just everything. Like I watch like what my mom or my grandparents have to go through, and it's like I don't really want to have to deal with that. Like I like being young. Like I enjoy being young to the point where I don't want to get older.
But that's the thing though, nobody stays young forever. We all grow old and we have to accept it or, you know, take the alternative.
I have Peter Pan syndrome.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, too, is like when you look at our pets, I mean, we do outgrow our pets. Our pets only have anywhere from what? Like your smaller dogs, anywhere from 10 to 12, 13 years. Larger dogs, anywhere from 8 to 10 years.
But smaller dogs are living longer, like 15, 16. The younger.
Because of good medical care.
Yeah, 7, 8 years.
But I mean, same with cats. I mean, they can go into the teens. I've known some that go into the 20s, but. I mean, we're going to outgrow those.
Yeah, my cat died in October, and he was 18.
18 years old. Mine are right now 15, 16 years old. And I could tell that they're winding down.
You guys are making me really sad.
But then, sorry, Zach. But then also, it's like, when you look at birds, I've got three parrots. They're going to outlive me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, within health, I mean, and you can probably answer this question, Dr. J, is like, I had heard with birds, they don't show illness very easily. I mean, pretty much they just drop to the bottom of the cage.
The smaller ones especially.
Leo did that last night. I was sitting there on the couch, really? And all of a sudden he's like, right down on the bottom of the cage. And I was like, did he die? And I looked and he's like, he fell asleep and fell off his perch.
What kind of bird? Which one is the
Leo? He's the Amazon.
Oh, what a nut. Well, he's just psycho. So. Yeah,
they all are. Take after daddy. 844-287-2876 is the number, 844-287-2876. But that's the one thing that's cool about having pets, though, is that technically, I mean, basically, they give us that unconditional love, and you don't find that in the human world as much.
That's true. But when you lose them, it's devastating. When I lost my cat,
I remember.
I not only felt grief, but I felt guilt because, you know, I'm a vet. I should be able to save them.
Well, you like we were just saying, and like Lexi's afraid of, you know, we all get old and we don't live forever. At some point, we all die. And whether it's from old age, sometimes it's not. There's an interesting movie that I just saw, The Fault in Our Stars, and I just screened it this week. And interesting movie about cancer and two young adults. And good movie to go see and check out. You'll get a lot out of it.
It was a book, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was a book, yeah.
By John Green. Yep, it's really good. I only read like the first couple of chapters.
Oh, wait until you see the movie.
Oh.
Good.
I can't wait.
You can read?
She's young. She's not. Well, once again, thanks for joining us in this hour of Talking Pets. Don't forget, check out Life's a Bark by Mr. Larry Kay. It's a great book out there in stores and online. I'm John Patch.
I'm Dr. Jared Lazarus.
And I'm Lexi Lapp.
And of course, I'm Zach Buden.
And don't forget, spay and neuter your pets and help control that pet population. If you're going to adopt a pet, go to your local animal shelter or your rescue group and adopt a dog, cat, or whatever from there. But thanks for joining us, and check out our website at talkinpets.com, TalkinPets.com, and please join us on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for joining us here on Talkin' Pets.
Let's Talk Pets, every week on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.